What is up, YouTube? Welcome back or welcome to my channel. If this is your first time, this is my channel, Pixie Dust and Spirit Alchemy, where we talk about all sorts of magical, taboo, supernatural, occult, mystical, supernatural topics, stuff like that. I got the inspiration from this video, I'll say, from a book that I actually talked about on this channel almost like 4 or 5 years ago. And I hadn't, that was back when I read it for the first time. And I recently familiarized myself with it again. And it has some fascinating features. And this book that I'm referring to is Real Magic by Dean Radin, PhD. And I'll post a link to that other video that I did here. Because there's a lot that I actually want to talk about with this book. So as I was re-familiarizing myself with this book, just rereading some of it and stuff, I came across this point, this topic that the author makes in one chapter of the book, which is the strength of a magical outcome is determined by four factors: clarity, imagination, emotion, and belief. As someone who has practiced magic and practices magic, I can speak on the validity of that statement from a non-scientific standpoint, but from an applied standpoint of experience, first-hand experience. And I completely agree with what he's saying, and I kind of wanted to talk about why each of those things is vital in strength and powerful in strengthening the outcome of one's magic. First being belief. The stronger our belief in anything, the more real it becomes. Believing is seeing, right? Because if we believe in something, we are more open to seeing it, not the other way around. We have to believe that the magic is going to work. Believe, especially in the world of metaphysics, we have to believe in it and believe that it works to some degree in order to see the results. And so if we believe, no matter even how strong our belief is, if we have that belief, and it is pure, and it is honest, then that alone strengthens the magical outcome. That alone allows the outcome, not even strengthens, that alone allows it to happen. That's just one of the keys to having the magic happen. Because if I walk the walk, you know, and do the ritual or whatever, and I don't even believe that it's going to work, then I'm not going to even see the results if it does work. I'm not open to seeing that. So number two was imagination. And I think imagination comes into this with, along with visualization. And imagining, the power to imagine how we want life to unfold, the life that we want to create, right? I mean, this could be taken many directions, whether we're imagining what a spirit or entity looks like, or imagining the energies at work, imagining different outcomes and different results and different manifestations, because our imagination is limitless. And so if we trust and pay attention to our imagination, then we can essentially manifest what we imagine, anything that we can imagine. You know, a broad imagination is a great playground for magic because the energy of the magic works with what we are able to imagine. So the broader our imagination, the greater our imagination, the more room the magic has to work in our lives. So the next one was emotion. And that should be pretty self-explanatory. I mean, emotional transmutation is one of the key factors in magic. And I do agree with the statement that the stronger your emotion, the stronger the outcome of the magic. There's a direct correlation. What is emotion? Energy in motion. So that energy that we are putting in motion and sending into a ritual and transmuting it is what is supercharging the energy to work and the results to occur how we want them to occur. Because what we put into it is what we get out of it. So the strength of our emotion, the strength of our belief, and the strength of our imagination are all key factors. And I would go further than to even say that they're just there to determine the strength of the outcome or to strengthen the outcome, but that they allow the outcome to happen. Because if we are closed off to emotion and belief and clarity, to emotion, imagination, and belief, then we aren't open to seeing a result manifest. And okay, maybe it manifests somewhere else, but does that even count if it doesn't, if we don't see it and it doesn't exist in our reality? Because we aren't open. You know, I don't want to do the magic and then have somebody else see the result when the magic's for me and then me not be able to see it. Believing in not only the magic, but believing in yourself too. Believing that I am capable of changing my life, of using magic, of using this supernatural means to create the life that I desire. The stronger our emotion, the stronger the magic. But first, we as magicians need to be in touch with our emotions. We need to know what it is that we're feeling. We need to be honest with ourselves. You know, be able to identify what's going on with us. And then send that out however we need to be transmuted or to charge the ritual. But most importantly, to know it and to feel it within ourselves first. And then lastly is clarity. I believe that this refers to a clear mind, a clear intention, knowing what it is I want, being firm with that, and having intensity there too. How bad do I want this? How badly do I want to change my life? How badly do I want that new car? How badly do I want to get this book publishing deal? How badly do I want this person to think I'm cute? How badly do you want it? Have clarity and know yourself well enough to know these things, to be honest with yourself about it. I think clarity also comes with being in the present moment. So the clearer your mind, the clearer your heart, the clearer your intentions, the stronger, the more deeply we feel our emotions, the broader our imagination, and the stronger our belief, the stronger the outcome of our magic will be. So if all of those things are maxed out at 100%, imagine the strength of the outcome that we can achieve, that the magic can work. Imagine the reality that can be bent, you know, and outside forces that typically act against magic, which by that I only mean reality inertia, right? Because when the magic works, it's having to, there's energies that are shifting, and sometimes there's counteracting energies just from normal life. I don't mean anybody like doing magic back at you or something. But it has to work within certain energetic paths. And if our belief and imagination and emotion and clarity aren't that strong, then sometimes those paths can be blocked, or sometimes the magic will take a different path to manifest. one that isn't as strong, because our energy, our passion, you know, wasn't in it to get that force of the magic over the inertia of reality that sometimes pushes back. If you want to strengthen your magic, strengthen your belief in yourself. Start with your belief in yourself. And then believe in the magic. Use your imagination, you know, become childlike in that sense again. Childlike wonder, where anything is possible. Feeling the depth of our emotions and not running from them. And knowing ourself well enough, having a clear enough focus, a clear enough mind, clear enough heart, to not be distracted, to not be influenced by what others want and think for us. Being in tune enough with ourselves to know clearly what it is that we desire and that we want to achieve. So, I hope that somebody has found this helpful today. If no one has read this, you know, if not anyone is familiar with this, again, it is Real Magic by Dean Radin, PhD. It references a lot of magic, like traditional magic, and it references a lot of stuff. He's not like some scientist that's out of place in the metaphysical world. Like, he balances them both well. If anyone has ever wondered or struggled with the strength of their magic not feeling at its full potential, then I hope that this video can help you to get it where you want it to be. You know? Because how bad do you really want it? Because if you want it that badly, if we want it that badly, we can have it. Like, it is ours. It exists for us. So thank you guys for taking the time to watch this video. There's a lot of energy going on. This will be published around the time of the full moon in July. There's a lot going on in the world, in America, in the world. So I hope everyone is staying safe, staying kind, staying curious, as always, and until next time, peace.